everyone, and welcome to another episode of Thought Leaders Tomorrow. Today we have with us Mr. Saurabh Vyas, who is the managing partner at Vyas Travels. Welcome, Mr. Saurabh.
Hi, Arabia, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing good.
So Mr. Saurabh has over 11 years of experience in the travel and tourism industry. He's handled various divisions. He's done sales, management, and pretty much everything. And today we are going to have a chat with Mr. Saurabh and understand his experience in the industry so far and hear what kind of insights he has to offer us about the travel and tourism industry. Shall we get started then?
Absolutely.
Great. So tell us a little about your journey in the travel industry, Saurabh. What's it been like so far?
It was all started when I was around 16 year old. I used to go to my office with my dad and my uncle in summer vacations. Those days I got a chance to see my employees making, you know, those coupon air tickets. I don't know, you might be knowing or not. But I was very curious about how to make those coupon air tickets. So I gave my hand to my employees to arrange those tickets, as well as I've been seeing, you know, those magazines from the airlines, from the tourism boards, from many events related to tourism activities. So this was the time gave me spark to get into travel industry, travel and tourism industry. After finishing my graduation in commerce, I wanted to pursue a professional degree in travel and tourism. As I was wanted to make practical, I wanted to be practical strong. So I wanted to join somewhere where I can get more practical knowledge. So I pursued my travel and tourism degree from New Zealand. And why New Zealand? Because New Zealand is tourism based economy. And while studying, I also work part time in a company where my profile was tour leader, to lead, you know, certain groups from
right.
Australia, from America, from China, from India. Yeah. So after returning back to India, I started promoting Pacific Island countries, because in Central Indian state where I am from, we are not focusing on Pacific Island countries such as Fiji, Australia, New Zealand, Cook Island. And with my gained knowledge, I have came across with some uncommon products to make unique experience, which will be valued added for my customer. So this is my small journey into travel industry so far.
That's wonderful. Sounds amazing. So how do you think, you know, young leaders like yourself can actually bring about a change in the travel industry today?
Younger leaders are key partners to driving travel industry. They are the one who introduced Uber, Ola, Oyo, Airbnb into the travel market. And I have a strong belief that because of the younger leader are in the tourism market, this market is going to be the first to overcome from the current situation, COVID-19. In travel industry, younger people playing vital role in terms of they are very creative, they are very digitally, technically sound, they are hardworking, passionate towards their work, and I'm sure they will bring more and more opportunities for the employment within the tourism industry. As I stated earlier, I joined travel business in very young age. Since then till now, I wanted to make products which is out of the box into the market. And that all came across because I've been traveling and exploring more and more countries and making amazing products out of my experience.
Wow, okay. So also, you know, given that you're a part of the younger generation and you're at such a senior position at your organization, do you think sometimes there are ideological differences between younger professionals and the older professionals in the travel industry? And how do you think that you can kind of deal with those kind of differences?
See, I have been working with the older generation employees and my family members, and many of time I have seen there are clash, which you can say ideological difference between a two generation. But what we have to do is to take their expertise, their knowledge, guidance on the first hand, all right, and then merge with yours and came up with the equal solution this will definitely give good impact to both the generation, younger and the older. As we have go a way forward with the help of older generation, as we have to go way forward with the help of old generation and under their surveillance, so that we will succeed in the tourism industry.
Absolutely.
Because they have more experience than us.
Yeah, balance is very important.
Yes, absolutely.
Right. Well, coming to one of the most burning issues, the coronavirus, how do you think the COVID-19 pandemic has impacted your organization? And personally, what kind of steps has your organization taken, you know, to kind of protect its employees in the present climate?
It is indeed a very bad time and industry is in a very bad shape, and our organization as well, and the whole travel fraternity. It affected our sale by 80-90%. It has affected our whole business nature, our business expansion, and taken us almost 1 year back. What we are saying that coming 8-10 months, it's going to be nil for our organization. But things will gradually picking up, you know, started. And we are more focusing on domestic travel products and towards the safety of the customers. And we will definitely target those hotels, those suppliers who are taking good steps towards this pandemic, you know. We are also advising our employees to gain more domestic knowledge, attain webinars of different tourism boards, different tourism states, countries, gather all their knowledge and make product considering customers' medical safety. And highest priority is their this current situation, COVID-19. We also advise our employees to do regular meditation to maintain a good health.
Absolutely. Yeah. So how do you think travel is actually going to change after coronavirus? You know, is there going to be a change in the way people approach travel? How is the industry kind of going to deal with that?
There will be definitely changes which will impact on the industry. Such as nowadays, as you know, from 25th of May, in domestic air travel started. But you are not allowed to travel if you are not downloaded the app called Arogya Setu.
Yeah.
By the government of India, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it is one of the major steps towards protecting yourself from COVID-19, and major step towards digitalization of industry. Airports nowadays are operational with no touching human being policy. Biometric machines are installed.
Yeah.
Passengers nowadays have to bring their own boarding passes. They have to bring their boarding passes, you know, prior to get into the airport. They also have to print their travel, travel bag tag. We are also getting social distancing kits, you know, from the airlines when we are getting into the aircraft. And hotels and restaurants are also coming up with the same sort of things. Travel agencies will also follow some guidance for operating their business units, how to maintain their cars, how to maintain their office. So if we talk about industry, then I am very optimistic that tourism industry will definitely bounce back to normal, and we will be getting more and more business. Everybody wants personal human touch, you know, while planning their holiday, especially when you are designing a luxury holiday.
Great. So my final question, Mr. Saurabh, to you is that what advice would you give budding leaders in the travel industry, or people who are inspiring to, you know, actually be a part of the travel industry? What advice would you give to them?
As per my knowledge and experience, I would suggest the individuals who wanted to join travel industry should listen to this. Firstly, if you must have a passion to travel, passion to explore new places, learn new culture, try different cuisines, and meet new people every day while focusing on building great relationship, then only you will definitely sell travel product anywhere around the world. Secondly, I would advise, if you want to sell travel product, you need to find your target market, your niche market. So there are more than 200 plus countries around the world. You cannot sell all those countries. So you need to sell some selected 5-10 countries with a unique and tailor-made, you know, itineraries which valued your client the most. And final but not the least, I would advise you must be hardworking, passionate, patient, individual, because travel industry work round the clock, as you never know from which part of the world your customer is needing your support at so what true. Time, you know.
Thank you so much for chatting with us, Saurabh. It was wonderful speaking to you.
My pleasure. Okay. My pleasure. Thanks. Thank you, Ravya.
Thank
stay
you.
Stay home, stay healthy.
Yes, you too.